हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम सागर जुमड़े फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड कम्युनिकेशन इंजीनियरिंग, गवर्नमेंट पॉलिटेक्निक, खमगांव। वेलकम यू ऑल इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज़ फॉर द कोर्स इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स मेजरमेंट एंड इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन। इन दिस वीडियो सीरीज़ वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न यूनिट वन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स मेजरमेंट एंड इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन, दैट इज़ फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स measurements, and this first video lecture is dedicated to the topic fundamentals of electronic measurements. Learning outcomes: after watching this video, learners will be able to define measurement, define electronic instruments, explain the block diagram of electronic measurement system, classify and explain different types of electronic instruments, compare absolute and secondary instruments, and the course outcome achieved by watching this video is classify the given measuring instruments. Now let us move towards the introduction. The measurement of any quantity plays very important role not only in science but in all branches of engineering, medicine, and almost in all the human day-to-day activities. The advancement in solid-state devices has brought significant change in the measuring instruments. The conventional electromechanical systems in measuring instruments are replaced by electronic devices. Or we can say that mechanical and electromechanical measuring instruments are replaced by electronic measuring instruments. As we all know that in our daily life we measure many things. So I would like to request you to think and reflect on following question, and the question is, what do you mean by measurement? Kindly pause your video and write your answers in the notebook for above question. After writing the answer, you can play the video. So, our question is, what do you mean by measurement? Here is the answer of that question. Measurement of a given quantity is the act or result of a quantitative comparison between a predefined standard and an unknown quantity to be measured. Let us understand this definition by taking one example. So example is, for measuring weight, the standard taken is 1 kilogram. Here, weight of a quantity is unknown. We have to measure the weight of that quantity, but we know the predefined standard, that is kilogram. This kilogram standard is already defined and universally acceptable. So we can compare weight of unknown quantity with the predefined standard, that is kilogram. Now you can take another example. If we have to measure length of something, let us say rope, then what will be the predefined standard? The predefined standard is centimeter or meter or kilometer, which is already defined and accepted universally. So we compare length of unknown quantity with predefined standard, that is centimeter, meter or kilometer, and the comparative result of that unknown quantity and predefined standard is your measurement. Now you can understand the definition of measurement by these examples. Now, in order to obtain meaningful results of measurements, there are two requirements First is, standard used for comparison purpose must be accurately defined and should be commonly accepted, like kilogram, centimeter, kilometer, etc. And second one is, the apparatus used and procedure developed must be provable. If these two requirements are satisfied, then we can say that the measurement is proper or accurate. Now, for measurement of quantities, we require instruments. So we see here electronic instruments. Electronic instruments can be defined as a device for measuring the value or magnitude of a quantity or variable. The electronic instruments are based on electrical or electronic principles for their measurement. Now, let us move towards the block diagram of electronic measurement system. The electronic measurement system is composed of following elements. First is transducer, or it is also called as sensor. Second is signal conditioning unit. And third is display device, or it is also called as indicating device. First, transducer. Now, transducer is also known as primary sensing or sensor element. What is the use of transducer? It converts physical quantities, example temperature, pressure, level, distance, etc., into electrical signal. Second block is signal conditioning device. Its function is to process the transducer output signal such that it is suitable for the display unit. This signal conditioning device involves amplification, filtering, scaling, etc. And the last is display unit or indicating device. It displays the quantity under measurement in terms of numbers and respective unit. In terms of numbers and respective unit means, for example, if we measure voltage, it displays 5 volt. So 5 is a number and volt is a unit. Display devices can be in the form of dial pointer, LED display, LCD display, etc. Now, advantages of electronic instruments. As previously we have seen that the mechanical or electromechanical systems or instruments are replaced by electronic systems or instruments. Because of lot of advantages of electronic instruments over mechanical and electromechanical instruments. And these advantages are, power consumption of these instruments is very less as compared to electromechanical instruments. Size is compact, very fast response. Display is convenient and effective. These instruments are used in measurement of non-electrical quantity like temperature, pressure, etc. Signal conditioning unit involves amplification, filtering, multiplexing, which is not possible in electromechanical instruments. And these instruments having high sensitivity and flexibility. Now, let us move towards the classification of measuring instruments. Electronic measuring instruments are divided into two types: secondary instruments and absolute instruments. Secondary instruments again divided into three types, that is indicating instruments, recording instruments, and integrating instruments. Now we will see one by one. First type of electronic instruments is secondary instruments. These instruments are constructed such that the magnitude of quantity can be determined only from deflection of the instruments. For example, ammeter, voltmeter, wattmeter used in laboratories. Now again, secondary instruments are divided into three types. First is indicating instruments, second is recording instruments, and third is integrating instruments. Now we will see the types that first is indicating instruments. These instruments indicate the magnitude of quantity to be measured. The indication is generally in the form of scale, or we can say dial and pointer arrangement. For example, ammeter, voltmeter, wattmeter used in laboratories. Here, figure shown for indicating instrument is ammeter. In this figure, there is a dial, or we can say scale, and red color pointer, which indicate the magnitude of quantity by using scale and pointer. Second type, recording instrument. Some process require a continuous record of measured quantity. Recording instruments are used for such purposes. The recording instruments give a continuous record of the variations of the quantity being measured. For example, temperature variation in a furnace, supply voltage variation in substation, ECG of a person, and earthquake measuring system. Here, figure shows ECG instrument, which is recording instrument. In this ECG instrument, there are continuous recording is taken place. Third type is integrating instruments. The integrating instruments integrates the quantity under measurements over a period of time. That is, it totalizes the events over a period of time. For example, energy meter, in which power is measured over a period of time, which gives measurement of energy. Figure shows energy meter, which is also available in our home. This energy meter totalizes the total electricity or total power over a period of time. Now, second type of electronic instrument is absolute instruments. These instruments give the magnitude of quantity being measured in terms of constant of the instrument. The formula for this: deflection of meter multiplied by meter constant. In absolute instrument, all the meters having some meter constant. Examples of absolute instruments are tangent galvanometer, current balance meter, etc. Figure shows tangent galvanometer. In this tangent galvanometer, reading is given by deflection of pointer and some meter constant. Now let us move towards the comparison of absolute and secondary instruments. Absolute instruments, these instruments read the quantity under measurement indirectly, that is, in terms of deflection degrees and meter constant. But in secondary instruments, these instruments read the quantity under measurement directly. That is, if it is ammeter, it reads directly in ampere. Example of these instruments: tangent galvanometer, current balance meter, and example of secondary instruments: ammeter, voltmeter, wattmeter, etc. Now, there are sample multiple choice questions with answers based on this topic. You can go through it. With this, we come to end of this lecture 1. Now let us summarize. In this lecture, we learnt about definition of measurement, definition of electronic instruments, explanation of block diagram of electronic measurement system, classification and explanation of different types of electronic instruments, comparison of absolute and secondary instruments. If you have any queries, suggestions, comments, kindly contact me on my email ID and mobile number. So with this, we have come to end of this first topic and this first video lecture. I thank you for being here. Thank you.